Welcome to Warriors Postgame Live, presented by Toyota, as the Warriors handle business on the first of a five-game road trip. Coming off a big win over the Denver Nuggets Monday night, they don't waste any time with OKC, blowing them out. And they were up 40-plus in this game, and Jordan Poole had a big game. He's standing by Bonte Hill, Chris Mullin, and Darrell Wright. Jordan, first of all, congratulations on the win. Big-time weekend here, beating Houston, then Denver, and then you take care of business tonight against Oklahoma City, and you came off the bench in the first half. Very aggressive, and you've been doing that over the last three games. What has changed for you with all the injuries happening to this team, especially with James Wiseman and Kelly Oubre Jr.?
Well, first and foremost, I want to thank God for being in this situation, and we wish a speedy recovery for James and Kelly to get back. But until then, just kind of holding the fort down. You know, the coaches and, you know, my teammates want me to come and be aggressive and, you know, kind of be the guy in the second unit. So just find a way to continue to give us a push and, you know, not let up after the first unit takes care of what they got to do in the game.
Jordan, what's up, man? It's D. Wright. You guys been locked in these last two games. Do you think this road trip you guys can go on your run?
I feel like this is the trip that we need to do that. You know, we got a little bit of momentum coming off of a huge win, and we beat Houston, and we got a big win tonight. So just find ways to keep our momentum going and try to get a streak going.
Jordan, Chris Mullin, congratulations. Great game tonight. Talk to us about what it's like being around Steph Curry. We watched him the other night break Wilt Chamberlain's scoring record in the Warriors franchise history. What it's like being around his greatness, and what kind of habits have you picked up from him in preparation and watching him each and every day?
It's absolutely amazing. You know, it's once, you know, once in a lifetime type of deal. And, you know, congrats to him and being able to hold that record. And it's just amazing. Night in, night out, seeing how he works. Today, he just went absolutely bananas in the third quarter. And, you know, like you said, it's greatness. And, you know, you got to, you know, be thankful to witness something like this and, you know, find ways to get tips and, you know, just watch what he does behind the scenes and try to add it to your game. But the guy is absolutely amazing and he's special. And he knows that and everybody else knows that. And we're just lucky to have him on our team.
Hey, Jordan, I know Draymond Green gives you a lot of grief for going to Michigan. Obviously, he's a Michigan State Spartan, but he drops his fourth triple-double tonight. He now has 28 in his career, which is first atop the leaderboard in Warriors history. Talk about Draymond Green and what he does for this offense when he's aggressive, when he's scoring, because it feels like he opens up everything when he is getting 8 to 10 to 12 points a night.
Yeah. Congrats to Draymond, you know, first and foremost. And, you know, he's a leader of our team, you know, and he does everything because he does intangibles. He does a lot of the stuff that doesn't show up in the scoreboard. But whenever he's scoring and he's being aggressive and he can get a basket, it just makes us more dangerous because, you know, teams got to guard him. And as soon as you come up, you know, the chemistry that he has and finding his shooters and finding Steph and getting other people open and getting involved is absolutely dangerous. So whenever he's putting the ball in the basket, it just makes us more of a dangerous team.
Hey, Jordan Poole, congrats on the win and a solid game tonight. Get some rest. Cleveland tomorrow night. We'll see you then.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
No problem. Jordan Poole here on Warriors Post Game Live, and he's coming along on the bench, having some very aggressive games, but it all starts with number 30, Stephen Curry. Back-to-back 40-point nights, back-to-back nights where he's hit 10-plus threes. Hit 11 tonight, Darrell. And look, he had it going early, and then like Jordan Poole said, the third quarter barrage there, it's just special.
Yeah, Bonte, we talked about this pregame. We said these guys have to come out tonight and set the tone early and jump on these guys right away. They should, and we also said fourth quarter, they should be on the bench icing up, and that's exactly what they did. But Steph Curry understood what he had to do. Don't take these guys for granted and come out and play a good game.
This was the perfect scenario on the first game of a back-to-back. Get the blowout win. Everyone feels good about themselves. They were sharing the basketball. They had, what, 37, 40 assists. Everyone got a piece of the pie. Steph and Draymond got to get on the bench for the entire fourth quarter. So this is the perfect game on a back-to-back, and you look at what's coming up next. Steph Curry, since the hip contusion, wow, has been, as Bonte Hill would say, on a heater.
On a heater. I don't even know what that is. I just made that up.
Well, if it was a heater, they turned the heat up. It got hotter. It's on fire now.
Steph Curry came in averaging over 38.5 in his last seven. That percentage goes up. That average goes up. The field goal percentage goes up. And the numbers here, you look at it, 42 points. He scored 40 in back-to-back games for the first time since a three-game 40-point streak back in 2016. We were just talking about him. The year compared to this year in 2016 when he won the MVP, his second award, it's the first time a Warriors player has had consecutive 40-point games since that man named Kevin Durant, who had three straight back in 2018. So this run is just absolutely special. And we look at the players who has had multiple 10 three-pointer games. He's now got 19 in NBA history. Yesterday, the other night, Durrell, we said 18. Okay, he's up 13 on Klay Thompson. Klay Thompson second there with five. Steph Curry now with 19 games with 10-plus threes. And I'm actually surprised, Willie and Durrell, that he doesn't have more 10-plus pointer games because he sat a lot of fourth quarters in 2016, 15-17, because the Warriors were blowing everybody out, Durrell. But this streak right here, that may never get broken.
That's super impressive. I had a conversation with my boy Quentin Richardson yesterday, and we were talking about Steph Curry making 10 threes in 18 games. We're both shooters. It's hard to do 10 in one game. So for him to do it 19 times is super impressive.
And he will add to that. There's more coming.
Yes.
No question about that. But what Steph Curry does, look, the points and the three-pointers are amazing, but the way he does it, off the dribble, and then when he gives it up, we see him relocating. He gets them in transition. And this year, more than ever, the defenses have really keyed on him without Klay, who's the other guy on that list, not in the lineup. So he's seeing two triple teams, double teams. And actually, he's gotten better. His efficiency has gone up these last 7-8 games. So it's been an amazing run for him. That's why I've changed my mind on this play-in. Because you know what? The play-in tournament, right. If I get a few more games of Steph Curry, I'm all in.
I mean, it's incredible. 25 points in the third quarter tonight. 25. He had 23 in the third quarter against Houston. And, of course, he had 48 through three quarters against the Denver Nuggets with a 21-point first quarter. I believe that's now 11 games he's had 20-plus quarter or a quarter with 20-plus points. That's like the most in the NBA since Kobe in the last 10 years. It's absolutely incredible here. And Durrell Wright has been a prophet here on the postgame, on the pre- and postgame show. Let's check out this from earlier today. Durrell Wright with another bold prediction. Durrell, total threes tonight between the Warriors and Thunder. Luke Dort had 7 last night against the Jazz. Pick wisely.
I'm going to go with 22. I like 22. Steph Curry might be making half of those.
No doubt about that. And of course, Steph Curry hits 11. Half of that. So this man, we got to go to Vegas or something. NBC Sports Predictor app, listen to this man right here. He knows what he's talking about.
Also said he was going to have 40 and three quarters, too.
He did say that.
They need to show that, too, man.
They need to show that, too. Give him his credit.
He right. He makes these outrageous predictions, and then Mully. Steph Curry comes through and makes it happen.
You call that, too, Mully.
That's crazy, dude.
That's crazy.
That's not
incredible.
So outrageous.
Not anymore. Right. Listen, how would you like to be – like tomorrow, you're the assistant coach that has the scouting report and how to defend the Warriors and Steph Curry. I mean, you might as well just be like, yo, dude, like, I'm done.
He's going to be
out.
Up all night.
Huh?
He up all night.
And it still doesn't matter.
It still don't
he
matter.
He can stay up for the next 3 nights. It does not matter.
Should he just go to sleep and say, you know what, coach? We can't stop this dude. Just, you know,
it's getting to the point where you're like, he's going to get his, let's control everybody else.
That's, good point.
That's
good
probably
point.
The only thing you can do.
And they need to control Draymond Green here because he's starting to pick up his play. You know, we talked about his game against Atlanta a few weeks ago where he didn't take a field goal attempt. Well, he's been a lot more aggressive. We saw it Monday night with 18-7-7. He drops a triple-double tonight, Durrell. And look, he was going to the rack. He was attacking. He didn't hit a three tonight, but you got to love the fact that he's going to the basket and looking for his. And look at the 16 assists that complements the points.
I love when Draymond's aggressive. When he's looking for a shot, it just opens the game. We heard what Jordan Poole said. When he's aggressive, we're a dangerous team. And he's not lying at all. So when Draymond's getting in there, you know, using his floaters, making guys better around him, it's always good, I think, in my opinion.
You see the 28 triple-doubles, which is the most in Warrior franchise history. Mm-hmm. So maybe Steph Curry will buy him a $4,000 bottle of wine. We'll have to wait and see about that. But when Draymond scores in double figures, it's just a beautiful balance to his entire game. His assist game is always on point. He's always going to rebound the ball. But the way the defense is key on Steph Curry, it is important for him to give us double figures.
Yes.
And it's just a more well-balanced attack for Draymond and the Warriors.
What is it about the small ball lineup that has given teams fits here? Because they've played well small this season.
I think the pace, I think them getting up and down in transition, they're able to switch everything on defense. And then on offense, they're able to put those bigs in that pick and roll, and then Steph Curry comes off. If you're not up on that screen and roll, Steph is either going to take that shot or he's going to be crafty and get to the basket. So I think they're taking advantage of all those things.
When you play small, there's two concerns, defensively, but Draymond and Looney can handle that, and then rebounding. They're a good team rebounding team, so I love this lineup moving forward.
Moses Brown is going to have nightmares tonight. We're going to hear from Steve Kerr on the other side about this big Warriors win.